What's up, YouTube? Current 6693 here. Here to bring you anime news as well as anything that I find interesting. Today, I want to talk about console parity. Because I know there's been an issue, and I know this is old news, but I know this has kind of been an issue lately. Especially with the controversy surrounding Assassin's Creed Unity and the whole thing with Ubisoft. And so for those of you who don't know, and I know this is old news, but I just kind of want to give my two cents on it. But for those of you who don't know, apparently one of the developers from Ubisoft apparently made a comment concerning why Assassin's Creed Unity was going to be 900p, 30 frames per second on both the Xbox One and the PS4. And apparently he basically said that they locked both consoles to avoid debate and stuff. And then once the controversy and the fanboy bitching arised, for good reason, but, you know, once all this stuff came, they basically retracted their statement, basically, oh, you know, we would never limit the experience of one console to another, you know, that's not what we do, and shit like that. Pretty much damn it controlling and pretty much lying to our faces, because one of the developers clearly said that they did it to avoid debate and stuff. There's only one way to interpret that. One console is more powerful than the other, and they stripped away some of the capabilities of one version of the game, of one console, to match the other, so fanboys wouldn't bitch. Now, there are many reasons why this is wrong, but let me just kind of, you know, explain why. For one, think about any product, you know, that you buy. You know, we buy anything, like shampoo, we buy food, even like physical materials, like we buy cars, we buy clothes, right? And we buy them, you know, because that's what we like. And they give us, and we want what we pay for, right? You know, they give us a certain experience that we enjoy, you know? It's kind of like buying different brands of shampoo, you know? You know, different shampoo has different a different smell, a different fragrance. And you buy different shampoo depending on which one you like. Now imagine with all the shampoo in the world, with all the different prices, they smelled and did the exact same thing and had the exact same quality of effect. You'd be like, well, what's the point of buying different shampoo that may look nicer in a bottle, or it may be a different brand, but it's the exact same thing? What's the point? It's kind of the same thing. Or what if you bought a car and you bought like a brand new, you know, Camaro versus buying like a hoopty or something like that. But both cars ran the exact same and did the exact same thing, regardless if the Camaro is very expensive. You'd be like, what's the point of having this great looking car if it doesn't do anything different? It's kind of the same thing with buying a console. What's the point of having different consoles if all the games are going to play the same? The point of buying the point of specifically choosing a PS4 or an Xbox One over the other is because you wanted, there was a certain experience that you wanted from one console that you did not see in the other, you know? And I think that equalizing the games to satisfy the lowest denominator of customers is not the way to go, because you get what you pay for, you know? I feel like it defeats the purpose of buying different consoles, and it's not good for the industry. I remember I come from a generation where a lot of these things didn't happen, where games could be completely different depending on which version you got on what console. I remember when Splinter Cell Chaos Theory came out on the PS2, I played that version, and then years later, I played the Xbox version. I was like, holy shit, this is a completely different game. I mean, there were sections of the level that were completely missing from the PS2 version that were in the Xbox version. The graphics, the lighting, the water, the texture, the environments, everything just looked better in the Xbox version. I can go back even further than that. I remember when the Spider-Man game came out on a Nintendo 64, and then it came out on a PlayStation 1, and then the PlayStation 1 had the cutscenes, and it had an entire game mode added on to that. So yeah, as you can see, games used to be completely different depending on which console you had. And I feel like that was how it should have been, because if you bought an Xbox One, you bought it knowing that it's less powerful than the PS4, right, or vice versa. You know, when you bought a PS4, you bought that knowing that it's considerably weaker than a PC. But you have to be okay with that, because that's what you paid for. And I feel like the way they're handling the situation now, I feel like it's kind of defeating the purpose of just buying a different type of experience. And I think this is something that we should fight back against, because if we allow this to happen, if we allow this to continue to happen, then we are going to see a lot of games do the same thing, and eventually we're going to end up paying all this money for these consoles, and we're going to get the same experience. Like, I'm like, my thing is, if they did this for the Xbox One or the PS4, how come they didn't do this for the Wii U? Because no games ever come to the Wii U anymore. How come they don't say we're going to downgrade the game for the Wii U so the Wii U can get in on the game on the multi-class as well? But they don't do that because they know fanboys will bitch and moan. You know, so if they won't do it for Nintendo, the Wii U, how come they're doing it for Xbox? You know, I feel like it's unfair. So let me know what you guys think. This is just my little 2 cents on it. I mean, you know, if you want me to go in more detail, I can. I really just kind of wanted to see how this new YouTube uploading thing works. Because as you guys know, the PlayStation 4 update 2.0 is out, and I'm kind of playing around with that. I do like the fact that you can change your themes. Although they haven't finished uploading the theme store on the network, so it's not up yet. But yeah, I'm really enjoying this PS4. Although I do wish there were more games to play, because I feel like there's only been a few games that have actually kind of lived up to their expectations. But anyways, that's for another video. So let me know how you guys like this video. I'll try to get a better mic because I know this one isn't the best one, but I'm just kind of working with what I got. I'm taking baby steps here, guys. I promise you, it'll get better. All right, I'll see you guys later. And if, like I said, rate, comment, favorite, subscribe if you want to see more. And I'll see you guys later. Current 6693 out. Peace.